My presentation is about the belief that the Earth is millions of years old. My trip to the Sahara Desert has brought my attention to revisit the Genesis account, much more when the tour guide showed me the fossils believed to be millions of years old. Fossils have been found in a 100 million year old river system that is now Morocco's Sahara Desert. Let me give the five views of Genesis 1:1 quickly. First view, Genesis 1:1 as a summary or title. If Genesis 1:1 is an overview of the succeeding text, then it is clear we are not told when God created the formless and void state of the earth. In verse 2, the beginning of the creation account is viewed as a mystery. Second view, the ruin restoration theory. Some Christians believe that Genesis 1:1 refers to the creation of this physical world and all life upon it at a moment of time long before the 7 days of creation week. This view believes that life existed on earth prior to Genesis 1, as observed in fossils dated billions of years old. Third view, the passive gap theory. This view understands Genesis 1:1 forms no part of the first day, but refers to a period of indefinite antiquity when God created the worlds out of nothing. Only non-fossil bearing rock can be dated billions of years old. Fourth view, creation of the universe on day one. This view sees the creation of everything in the universe, including Lucifer and the angels, on day one of the 7 day creation week several thousand years ago. Fifth view, the traditional creation theory. They believe that God created the world in several stages. The first stage was the creation of heaven, supported with several pillars. Thus, verse 2 describes the condition of the earth immediately after the creation of heaven and earth and before the creation of light. Several Bible translations have a different interpretation of the first two texts of the Bible. The Revised Standard Version put it this way: in the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void. The Genesis account is clear. Vegetation was prepared in day 3, then followed by the creation of moving organisms on day 4. Vegetation produces oxygen to sustain the life of the moving organisms. So there is a balance between plants and animals known as symbiotic relationship. Before the earth was created, there are already existing creatures. As Job says, "Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me, if you have understanding, when the morning stars sang together and all the sons of God shouted for joy." Thus, Genesis 1:1 would not describe a creation out of nothing, but rather could open the understanding that God and matter existed eternally side by side before the 7 day creation week. Some theologians agreed that the word heavens only focuses on the atmospheric heavens that surround this earth and does not include the universe that constitutes the starry heavens. In Genesis 1, in the context of creation, the phrase formless and void refers to the unorganized state of the earth before the 7 day creation. Verse 2 describes the state of the earth during the time when the activity of verse 1 was ended, thus making it clear something happened in verse 1 prior to the creation week. Accordingly, this earth already existed when God began the creation week in an unformed state. The breakthrough of carbon dating introduces a new scientific rigor to archaeology, allowing archaeologists to put together a history of humans across the world. But it had a significant effect in other fields, like theology. The various dating techniques all have limitations and inaccuracies due to the mishandling of samples. Accordingly, verse 1 does not seem to speak of the creation of the entire universe in its totality, but of the cosmos and its surrounding heavenly sphere. In such special creation, God has given this world its unique and full meaning, as well as history that moves on into the future. The work of creation can never be explained by science. The theory that God did not create matter when he brought the world into existence is without foundation. In the formation of our world, God was not indebted to pre-existing matter. Finally, the view that supports that the earth was created raw, in stateless form or void, prior to the seven-day creation week is closely possible. This can answer some fields of science, like archaeology and geology, as to why there are thousands and millions of years in carbon dating.